call her babe. That's her man.
Let me tell you, though. Let me finish.
You're not his best friend?
No, we're together. But he was telling me that you was, like, calling him. He was like, one of my old friends calling me. She's saying she need advice and stuff like that. I was like, okay, cool. So you came to his house, but instead you was, like, trying to come on him. You was trying to get on the couch. He said you was being pushy, so he had to put you out. And I was like, a friend?
First of all, I've known him for about 10 years. We have sex every time we see each other.
What's up, world? It's your girl, Sierra. I'm the CEO of one of the hottest salons in Atlanta,
the Glam Shop.
The shop has definitely been my dream since I was 16 years old. I got my start from doing makeup in the back of the club for dancers.
What's up, Mariah?
Hey, girl. You got a client.
But in the end, it all paid off. I glam up celebrities now. Actress, models, socialites, you name them. They all fall up in the glam shop.
The energy is so good in here. What's different? Oh, your girl, where she at? Lovely Mimi, she ain't here today?
No, she called out today.
Besides my assistant, Mariah, I have 13 stylists that works beneath me. Sometimes they act like unruly children.
We need to talk. You need to come on over here.
But I got this new nail tech, Lovely Mimi. She's the most rowdy of them all. I hired Lovely Mimi a couple of weeks ago because Mariah told me to. She got over 1 million Instagram followers, and Mariah was so convinced that it'll be good for the glam shop. But since the day she walked her ass up in the glam shop, she has been so loud. And guess who I blame? Mariah's.
Look at the atmosphere. It's so much peaceful without her in here.
She bring that little spirit up in here. Like,
that bitch is so all over the place. And I understand what you're doing. Like, you're trying to make her feel comfortable, but bottom line, our relationship go deeper than Lovely Mimi. You were letting her see you taking up for her. Don't do that. Even if you're gonna take up for her when she's not around. Don't let no bitch ever see you jumping on their side, period.
I'm Mariah, and working for Sierra has not been easy. She's been doing my eyebrows since I was in high school. And finally, her hubby, Shooter, convinced her to hire me. As her assistant and marketing director, it is my job to bring in the business. And Mimi is good business.
Who cares if she's loud?
I don't feel like you should just come at me mad because I welcome in her with open arms. Like, I am so loyal to you, and I help you with the business. We bring in this money.
Okay, Mariah.
Shouldn't have to question our friendship.
Mariah has been with me for a little over a year and a half. I trust Mariah. She's smart. But I just hope she remembers where her loyalty lies, and that's with me.
You know, like, you mean a lot to me and the glam shop.
I just felt like you was Team Mimi. I just felt like you was, like, bump me.
I'm Team Sierra and Team Mimi.
Team Sierra and Team Mimi?
Yes!
Girl, See, you done lost it.
Wow, what's happening?
I'm chilling, man. You know me. God first, family second, and bullshit. Never.
I've been trying to play nice with Carla ever since I dropped that little bomb on her at a photo shoot. And since I'm on the road with these double dates, I figured, you know, I'll take Carla out, one of her good friends, and her husband, Shooter, who I've known for quite some time in this music industry.
So what you been up to, bro?
So right now, man, I'm pushing a new single. You know, I got the morning show. What about you?
Same old man, just, you know, studio, man. Hey, I'm Shooter. I've been knowing Jock a while now from the industry. And my wife and Carly, they seem to be good friends. I'm thinking this date night will be a distraction from all the bullshit going on in my life right now. I've been in the studio so much, causing problems in my house, bro. Cause my wife don't approve of that.
You gotta figure it out, you gotta balance it.
Yeah, my wife work more than me. Me and my wife, Sierra, we've been together for 8 years, but we've been married for 7. Most of the time, it was all love. But lately here, we've been struggling. Yeah, we barely see each other. And when we do, it seems like we always fussing and fighting. I guess it be like that sometimes when we both out here hustling hard. I got my music and my wife, she have a pretty glam shop. And lately, I'm paying that's all she care about.
Oh, you getting a chair tonight? Ooh. How cute.
You're Shooter.
Hey, what's up? I'm Sierra.
Hey.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Sierra has been slaying my eyebrows for a while, and we've become good friends. But I think Jock used her as bait just to get me here tonight. He knows that I'm pissed off about that bomb he dropped on me at the photo shoot.
I'm so happy that we finally got a chance to, like, go out. We needed it.
We've been having a lot of drama lately.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Tell us about it. What?
It's a
certain couple, and they're married too. The husband stepped out and had a baby.
This one right here
done slept with the girl, and now the baby could possibly be his.
Here go Carly, throwing me under the bus. I didn't have no baby by this girl.
Innocent to proven guilty, my boy.
You need to shut up. You don't know what's going on. Right. What I got going on is not compared to what y'all got going on. I'm talking about at the shop. I got a new girl. Her name is Lovely Mimi. This bitch acting so loud, like,
just ghetto.
Ghetto is f***. Well, guess what? The bitch is out. The bitch is out.
That's enough about swipe work. No swipe. Work. I'm sick of hearing about work, baby.
Don't do that.
Free, I'm talking right now.
Don't do that.
Bro, listen.
I'm at work. Guess what I'm doing? I'm making money again.
Money. That's all you're talking about.
I've worked real hard because I started from the bottom. I had my daughter when I was 15 years old, and my mama wasn't going for that. She threw me right on out the house. But now, I'm a boss-ass bitch.
Just ain't doing what you're supposed to do at the house.
I like to work because I'm a boss. Guess what? You're my husband, so you're my other half.
Can I ask y'all a question?
Uh-huh.
Oh, this go left? So you're not domesticated?
No.
You know what'll fix that?
Fixes everything.
It's power.
And fixes everything, too. My husband, Shooter, is not doing what he needs to do in the bedroom. And I'm young and sexy. I need what I need. If I was getting on a regular, getting that recharged battery pack, bitch, I would be walking around here cooking, cleaning, baby. Do you need this right here, this right here, right here?
You know what? I don't heard enough of this
shit. What you mean?
Hey, bro.
Shoot. You always leaving. What do you mean? You are not about to leave.
Say goodnight to the bad guy.
No, you need to sit down. You need to come back and leave. No, you don't need to leave. You need to stay.
That may have been the shortest, most uncomfortable double date in history. These two have been together for so long. They have a beautiful family. It's sad to see them not getting along. Jock and I may have our issues, but at least we enjoy each other's company.
What's going on?
So please tell me what these folks saying are true. Lovely Mimi told me that you and Mariah had sex with each other. Please tell me that ain't true. Please answer me.
It didn't go just like that.
So you did?
It's some shit that happened.
So you had sex with Mariah? You f***ed Mariah before?
You gonna let me explain myself?
No, you ain't got shit to say to me. You can't explain nothing. I don't even know you no more. Like, who are you?
I made a mistake, baby. Me and Mariah might have a little thing going on, but it wasn't nothing like that. I got her a job at the glam shop, put money in her pocket, and hell, she wanted to return the favor. All I can think of is Mariah trying to get back at me because I wouldn't invest in her club. Listen.
I'm ready to go.
Is you gonna listen? Is you gonna listen while
Mariah.
I'm trying to talk?
Oh, so you had sex with Shooter?
Now I understand that 911 text from Sierra. I was just threatening you. I wasn't really gonna say nothing, but you told? What an idiot.
Are we before? That's hey, what you saying?
This gonna come out anyway.
So you gonna throw me under the bus?
Mariah.
You're not gonna say your
You better watch your mouth.
Watch my mouth? You the one who f***ing started? What the f*** are you saying?
I don't f*** you like that.
That's what we do now?
Yeah, we don't do
that's
that.
That's what we do
now? I don't f*** you like that.
Is y'all for real? I stood by your side all these years. You got kids, baby mama drama that I deal with, all this shit that I put up from you, and you had the fucking nerve to cheat on me with the help.
You better go out there and tell them you ain't been around with me the whole time. You the one who started this Mariah, shut the up. Don't check me, check you. I'm not the one who checked.
So y'all did all this to me? For real, to me?
Tell her how much you gave me. Tell her everything. Tell her how you gave me $20,000.
You little broke ass
old
man.
You got milk, and I put all that money in my savings account. Y'all guess what you gotta do? You gotta stop this, because I ain't make no promises to her. I ain't bounce with them doing part.
Y'all, listen, I'm too player for this. I gotta go.
I don't need you. I got my own. You was just another sort.
And you was convenient.
I hate you, bro.
I didn't know if I would ever recover from everything that happened to me last year. I found out that my husband of 8 years was smashing my assistant, and after that, my whole world fell apart. But then, I found someone new.
You look cute.
You look good too.
Thank you.
Somebody that won't lie to me and that's helping me learn how to trust again. And I have to say, I've never been happier.
Is it this way?
It's so nice, BK. Look at the view. Oh, my God. I can't believe you did all this for me. I love it.
BK and I was introduced to each other a few months ago when I was at the lowest point of my life. He was my friend before anything else. And honestly, I don't even know what I'd do without him.
This is so romantic.
I'll be trying.
And that's why I just love you.
Do you love me?
Do you love me?
I'm asking you. You
no,
said
I'm
it.
Asking you.
It slipped out. I mean, you probably do love me, but it's okay.
And you probably love me too.
My best friend.
And Ciara's special to me. She's a boss, a go-getter, and plus she's sexy as hell. But deep down, I hear that church boy from Brooklyn saying, you can't mess with this woman. She's married to Shooter.
You say you over homeboy, but are you really?
Yes, I just was unhappy the whole entire time. I'm so ready to move on. The divorce is almost final.
Oh, word?
And I'm just focusing on what we got going on.
What you think we could be, like, cause you just out of relationship. You gotta give it some time for the dust to settle.
What are we doing right now?
I feel like you're my best friend.
Okay.
And I just wanna continue to have fun. I feel like titles with me, it start to mess up things.
I am enjoying this feeling. We having an amazing time.
So let's leave it.
Let's
right
just there. Enjoy it.
Yeah, I think we should toast to new beginnings and
okay.
Success.
All right.
Let's take a shot and wait for Sierra and Tokyo to show up.
A shot of champagne?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, all right. Word got out that I was sniffing for tea about BK. And Amber Pretty, a dancer who's been around Atlanta forever, reached out to me with some very important information. I know my girl Sierra is in love, and she's not gonna believe anything I have to say without some proof. But I'm not trying to start any fights, so I rented out a super classy place where we can all sit down and talk and invited Mimi along just so she could keep the peace.
Hey, boo!
Hi, ladies.
Hey, boo.
Hey, y'all.
Hey.
Hi.
I love you.
Thank you. Hello. I'm Sierra.
Amber, Sierra, Sierra, Amber.
I've seen her face before.
I don't know why Carly invited me out tonight, but I do know this chick, Amber. That's BK's old friend, and he has told me some pretty wild stories about her.
What is all this?
It's fancy.
I bought us a crown today for a friend intervention. There's some things that one of our friends' boyfriends have not been honest about. He's been doing a lot of dirt, a lot of secret, and a lot of lies. There's one person in here that's new to the table.
No, but it looked like I seen her before. BK was just showing me her picture the other night. What night?
Like 2 days ago?
Like a couple days ago, yeah. He was like, babe, one of my old friends is calling
babe?
Me.
Babe?
He was telling me.
Oh, he called you babe?
Yeah.
He called her babe. That's her man.
This,
yeah.
Her man.
Let me tell you, though. Let me finish.
You're not his best friend?
No, we're together. But he was telling me that you was, like, calling him. He was like, one of my old friends calling me. She's saying she need advice and stuff like that. I was like, okay, cool. So you came to his house, but instead you was, like, trying to come on to him. You was trying to get on the couch. He said you was being pushy, so he had to put you out. And I was like, a friend?
First of all, I've known him for about 10 years. We have sex every time we see each other.
Nah, I don't believe this.
Oh, I got receipts.
Well, it's tax season, so we won't see him.
I don't gotta lie to you.
Brasco, so you said you had sex with him on Friday.
You had sex with him on Friday?
That's what she told me.
I am getting really tired of all of these randoms coming up to me with information about my man. So I'm not so sure if I should believe this chick who got all of this lipstick all over her teeth.
This is Monday at 10:23 p.m. He said, I'm in the crib. I said, get up, let's go out, have a drink. He said, it's fake going on outside. That's why I stay in my crib. Pull up on me.
Mm-hmm.
I need advice.
I mean, I know people make up fake texts too.
Fake text?
Mm-hmm.
Girl.
Okay, so did you have sex?
Yes, we had sex.
BK is a dog asshole. But this whole setup, a little messy for my taste. And I'm side-eyeing Carly for bringing Sierra face-to-face with her dude side chick. All right, so let's get to something better. You him, and this is all it is, so now what?
He says that that's not his girlfriend.
Well, I just told you that is his girlfriend, so now what?
Hey, Joy.
Hey, I am so confused right now, but then Joy walks in. I do her eyebrows and we cool, but I just don't get how she fits into this friendtervention.
Y'all, this is Joy. I actually do her eyebrows, and she's actually BK's artist. They work together doing music and stuff like that.
Hold on. He told me he messes with you, too.
Excuse me, who?
Brasco.
What?
I thought you said she was his artist.
Yeah, it is his artist.
He just told me about her on the phone.
Yeah, that's his artist.
Who are you?
Working together.
I'm Amber. Nice to meet you.
No handshake.
Okay. But he told me that he messes with her.
No, they don't mess around, sweetie. I'm sorry.
This is the conversation you and I need to have. I respect you. I like you. You and I are cool. We have no drama, no beef.
Oh, so y'all like
It's complicated.
Is it complicated or y'all Which one? I need you to sum it up real quick.
So, Joy, you see him post me all the time.
You wanna felt the way like, oh, he always with Sierra.
We've had these conversations. He says that you're his best friend. You do business together.
I'm dead.
So this is just a conversation that me and him have had.
I'm so dead.
Y'all best friends, y'all do business.
We're in the process of making it official. We're dating, but we're serious. I know his mama, I know his kids. We travel together, we do everything together.
You wanna hear that you're his best friend? Cause I have that too.
Okay.
You take the conversation.
Cause I knew this was gonna happen. I'm not, Carly, oh. Come.
Sierra's my real, like we really, like that's my real best friend.
That's my real best friend.
I mean, he ain't saying like they was friends though.
Like with Joy.
Who is Joy?
This other girl.
Oh, so you got another girl too. So yeah. Now you see where I get the best
no,
friend from.
He told me where you're
I still don't
from.
See where she who I she is.
Been f***ing him 10 years.
You lying right now.
I'm like, it's too much going on. You set it up, though. But you
no,
my friend. It's so funny to me how nobody ever thinks to just come to me and have a private one-on-one conversation. Did Carly really believe that I wanted to hear that my man was cheating from his side chick? All of y'all, what y'all saying? I don't give a I'm gonna go check him myself.
Joy, you should have came to her. You she do your eyebrows.
You don't even know me. You don't have no time to give mad at me.
Bitch, I don't give a fuck. This is why I'm mad at you. Let me tell you why. Because you she do your eyebrows.
Because you don't know me.
This right here is a whole hot mess. And Carly must be feeling a little guilty because now she's trying to flip on Joy. I know Carly had good intentions, but sometimes a little direct one-on-one might do the trick. The crazy part is, even with all these receipts, Sierra is still ready to stand by her man. Guess Carly ain't so crazy after all.
You don't want this smoke, so you all right?
Mm-hmm, girl, it's been a trip, but it's been a good trip.
I wasn't feeling you the other day at all, and I just wanted to tell you that I was really upset you told Spice that Tokyo said f*** you and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So I was just like, damn, why you had to tell Spice what Tokyo said? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, and at that moment, Tokyo was going in on me and Spice. She was like, f*** you, both of y'all. Mm-hmm. So I'm glad that they hashed it out and they good.
Ain't nobody being messy when I told Spice what Tokyo said, but she's making me realize that that's how she talks. She should have just said F the whole situation.
I just want to make sure as a friend that you're okay. I know you were saying that you are going through with your dad. Just want to make sure that you're okay. I appreciate that. Yeah, I'm doing better. I mean, I would like for you to check on me more. I need some attention.
Okay, I can do better.
Once BK got involved.
Oh my God,
he did the girlfriend. You know how it is when you get a man.
I know.
But I'm still here as your friend. Well, I don't want to be in the middle of your but I got your back. So if I need to be in the middle of your don't mess with my friend.
I know y'all talking, but let me take it for a minute.
Oh, okay, yeah, please.
I was really hoping Sierra was done with BK after she found out that he was smashing half the chicks in Atlanta. And seeing how he got aggressive with me and Estelita, and now he's trying to weasel his way back in. But I know Sierra can't take my realness, so I'm staying way out of Sierra's business from now on.
Oh my God.
I love you. See the rose petals? I did this to show you that I really care and I really love you. Like, I've never been in a relationship with a woman that was my best friend. And you're not just my best friend. I want to be that man for you.
Well, I just don't want you to think that you could just do stuff like this. This is nice and the effort counts, but You can't just think I'm just gonna give in. The things you've put me through is really hurtful, knowing the situation that I previously got out of, and then I thought I found my best friend, my lover, the person I wanted to, you know.
You say you thought?
That's what I'm saying. I thought that I did, but then when you do something so tragic as far as the Amber and the Joy situation.
But the Amber situation, the woman's lying on me.
It just still don't add up to me.
And I'm telling you, it didn't happen.
Okay.
But that's neither here nor there, because I want you, and I know you want me. Deep down inside is a hope. I know there's still a light shining for me because of the way we make each other feel. You said the divorce is final. The papers are in, right?
Yeah, they are in, but I still haven't signed the papers just yet.
Well, when you sign them divorce papers, we can go full throttle. I could just prove myself to you to show you that I am the guy that made you fall in love. I could be everything. You know that.
Mm.
And the next time you cry, you'll cry when I'm putting a ring on your finger.
All right, well, we'll see.
Bittersweet. When me and Shooter said our wedding vows, I never thought it would end with a divorce. I feel like I'm supposed to be sad, but really, I just finally feel free.
Today is the day.
Yes, yes.
Are you ready? How you feel?
Feel alright. I'm about to say.
I feel good.
No one can get married and thinking they're gonna end up getting a divorce. Back in the day, me and Sierra was deep in love. We had nothing, just me and her. But hey, things changed. I know I haven't always done right by Sierra, but I am sorry. But she played a major part in this too.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, Sierra. Good, we're gonna get this divorce done today.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm gonna give you a few minutes to discuss it. But once we get this done, I'll get it to the courthouse and we'll be almost divorced. We'll get our final judgment and decree in about 10 days.
Thank you.
You're okay. Welcome. So I'll be right outside.
You know, we've been separated for a year now. I just don't want this divorce to affect our kids.
Right.
At the end of the day, we still family. It's all love. We still family. We had our ups and downs, but you came in and you was a blessing to my life, you know?
Right.
Even though we not so compatible.
Even though I put you through a lot, I don't blame you. I blame myself for the majority of the shit I did. I just felt like when it was time to go our ways, I felt like it was a hell of a little wrong.
I just was tired. I had been so sick and tired for so long and so unhappy for so long that it was just like when I broke loose, I just had my running shoes on. The way I kind of left, maybe God just got me out of there because you was doing so much stuff that you got a baby out here.
That's not true.
We you got a baby out
blood
here.
Blood test on the way.
Do you have a 2-year-old child or not?
Hey, man.
It's a possibility.
It's a possibility that the baby might be mine.
Okay.
Maternity test will be here next week.
It really doesn't matter if Shooter is the dad to that other child or not. This marriage hasn't been right for a long time. And there's no doubt in my mind that this divorce was the right decision for the both of us.
I just feel like we're doing the right thing by signing these papers. I want you to go out and be happy, live your best life. I'm living my best life. It says mother right here and it says father right here.
Yes, yes.
Hey,
okay.
Well, how about
ready?
This paperwork?
Everything
yeah,
good?
It's
okay.
Signed, we're ready. It's all
Everything
yours.
Everything good to go? I'm gonna get it to the court. The judge will sign off on it. I'll send over a final judgment and decree. And we'll be done.
All right.
Okay. If you have any questions, you just give me a call.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, sweetie.
See you later.
All right, sweetie. If I call you, I need you. Hopefully, I won't be needing you.
Well, let's pray for the best.
What's going on? If Tokyo wants heart disease or diabetes, then fine. But I know that's not what Tokyo wants for herself.
You know why I'm over here, because you stormed out of the gym. And one of the whole reasons why we started this was to help you. No, I do not want that.
Tokyo's diet and health worry me because I had my own health scare. I was going to have to take insulin at 25 years old because I was obese and overweight. I'm with Tokyo all the time, and I watch how she eats, like, all of these greasy foods and candies and sweets and all of this crazy stuff. I'm just saying it's better things to eat than the things that Tokyo is eating.
this you eating?
It's pasta with broccoli in it and chicken. I've spent 24 years of my life becoming accustomed and liking the person I am just to get around motherfuckers in this industry, motherfuckers who are around me, who want to change me and change everything about me.
My brand is body positivity and loving what you look like, whether you big, small, short, or tall, and I'm not going to be a hypocrite about it. It's already a million people on Instagram who don't like me for being big. I don't need my friends telling me that I already know. I was fat when I woke up this morning.
I understand everything that you're saying, Tokyo. I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with being thick or heavy set. My thing is, I had a diabetes scare. I lost over 60 pounds because they told me, if you don't change your life, then you may not be here. So I'm saying that you need to lose a little weight to be more healthier.
Y'all want to keep coming in here and telling me what I need to do and this and that. And for you to come in here and think that you gonna insult me, you out your motherfucking mind.
But look what you eating.
Cause that's what the I want.
Cause it's gonna turn into sugar.
It's okay, Sierra.
No.
It's okay.
You need to lose weight. I'm throwing this away. Like, you need to do that. Cause this is gonna turn into motherfucking sugar.
It does not matter, Sierra. It does not matter.
That is not good.
You eat a lot of that's not good for you.
That is not good for you. None of this bullshit, because it ain't nothing but
the
bullshit. And that's what pisses me off.
What needs to piss you off is the things that you choose to do.
It don't matter.
And you coming in here trying to alter, but I don't know that. No, what you need to do is alter. What the f*** you got going on? No, you gotta keep your mother out of my house. Tokyo,
Tokyo.
I'm telling you, you gotta keep your mother out of my house.
Tokyo,
I can't believe you.
Tokyo.
I can't believe you. And you get the f*** out. Because I don't even want to go there with you, because you know what's up with me.
Tokyo, Tokyo.
So what do y'all think about the cabin? I mean, I feel like it's
no,
pretty.
I need a room change.
Where's your
why?
Room?
What's wrong?
I don't have a bathroom in my room. I have a bathroom outside my room. That means if I want to pee in the middle of the night, I sleep naked. I got to go all the way outside, let everybody see me naked.
You sleep naked in random beds?
Girl. You can't do that, girl.
I got an idea.
I'm just saying.
I like my room. I got a bathroom and everything, and I'm not switching
out. Can I get your room?
You can come spend the night with me. We ain't doing no freaking shit.
No.
I might need that room, honey.
Hold on. Why you switch your rooms here?
I just think I might need a bed by myself.
This shit got nasty.
Oh, BK, I need to talk to you in the kitchen for a second.
To hear what I heard about BK sliding up on Pooh at my birthday trip, nah, you way out of line.
I'm just trying to get to the bottom of why. On my ride down here, I hear that you and Pooh on my birthday trip to Cancun was flirting with each other.
First of all, who told you that?
Carly told me that.
Carly?
Yes, she did.
Carly Red?
Yes, Carly Red. Who else?
This is the same girl that tried to expose me and Sierra in that messed up intervention.
There's some things that one of our friends, boyfriends, have not been honest about.
We have sex every time we see each other.
And I just hope Sierra really is not listening to this girl all over again.
Carly. Okay, what happened?
A while ago, on a chat, it came through a message. It was like something about Pooh and BK.
As soon as the situation happened, you supposed to came to me and told me what happened.
It was nothing to tell you.
You should have been talking 6 months ago.
It's nothing to talk about.
It is something to talk about.
It is something to talk about.
It's nothing to talk about.
Ramel, just
apologize.
Carly,
no, he don't have...
Me and Pooh had a conversation in Cancun about how I'm treating my girl, how I'm doing my girl, but that was about it. And I never mentioned it to Sierra because I knew I would have to deal with this bullshit.
You really need to get your ass the back to what, up the road.
Listen, call me.
No.
Stop it now, you're going too far. You're going too far.
Since we all like having our moments of truths and we just throwing it out there, I just want to say that I did some things that I probably shouldn't have done in our relationship. You remember when you was going through my phone and you seen those DMs with the guy? So around the time when that happened, we were seeing each other and I did spend some time with him. And, you know, some things happen. So I want to say I apologize for that, since we all just keeping it real today.
Wow.
Ooh, child.
Oh.
Pinks, purples, reds.
I call it popping pink.
Ooh, okay.
The stuff with Pooh and Carly went from ridiculous to complete insanity. Both sides are not backing down, and all of this mess is sucking in everybody else, including me.
What's been up with you?
Bitch, I'm finna go to Trinidad.
Yeah, me too, bitch.
Bitch, I'm going to Trinidad.
I'm going.
Me too, bitch.
You going?
I don't know if I'm ready to make Trinidad.
Why you not going to Trinidad?
Girl, I just got so much stuff going on.
That
it don't got nothing to do with that.
Girl, yes,
they
do.
No, it don't. I haven't been with BK at all, baby girl.
Who the rose is from?
Who the rose is from?
Don't worry about who sent me. I got a secret admirer.
You have a secret admirer. It's not BK.
BK had one more chance. He done cut his last chance, and I'm not going back.
We all know that I've taken BK back a million times after he's done some lame-ass cheating. But this time, I'm done. And clearly, it's been a line of guys that's been waiting to replace his ass. So who needs him?
Listen, after the cabins, you already know what went down, bitch. So stop acting like you
well,
got
amnesia. Well, I wasn't there.
I wasn't there to feel
girl,
me.
I'm thinking I'm about to have a great time. Then Carly comes telling me, like, oh, friend, I forgot to tell you about BK and Pooh. So I'm like, bitch, why the f*** you ain't tell me 6 months ago? A few weeks ago, I had a conversation with Pooh. Me, you was there. Pooh was all lollygagging, all up in my face, hee-hee, ha-ha, and mentioned nothing about the whole BK and her situation.
So, Miss Keto Diet, who you trying to stay fine for? BK?
Girl, we been chilling. But on the flip side, he do one more thing, he's out the f***ing door. Period.
That's gonna be our new word.
Period. I just think it's a whole bunch of fake going on.
I tried to get Pooh and Carly together to try to talk this out.
I was waiting for that, bitch.
So wait, so who threw this cocktail party, which none of y'all
I
came
going to?
Carly comes, soon as she walked through the door, it was some bullshit. Pooh was really trying to have a conversation with. She really was. Carly was not hearing it. When I tell you this got so ugly, who ended up picking up this big ass bar stool?
Oh my God.
You ain't gonna do.
Who mad that I left her alone?
I know Pooh and Carly very well. I like both these girls, but I'm not gonna be the one to take sides. I'm gonna stay out of this, and I pray these two girls work this out between themselves.
So, girl, y'all ain't heard the tea by Shay Mack.
And what happened?
Maid man, he a ho-ho. She was at my house at 3 o'clock in the morning, coming over there talking about this motherfucker. She done found some rubbers, girl. She said she ain't never fucked with a rubber.
Wow. Ooh.
So look, Tokyo, I know you say you're not keeping the session, mm-mm, but you keep the session with that bastard. I got something for him for that session. Don't say nothing.
I don't mind keeping my session with Mad Man because we already done spent the money on it. Shekinah, girl, you go ahead and do what you gotta do because the bitch probably deserve it.
You know, she kind of feel like the world over a little bit for her. That girl is sad about this.
Hi, y'all. Oh, no, don't look stunned to see me.
Hey, Pooh.
Hi.
I tried to squash the beef with Carly, but she wasn't having it, and neither was I. But I have a serious issue about what she was telling the other girls. I'm disappointed that Sierra wasn't at my cocktail party because BK tried to talk to me, and I shut it down.
I wanted to come talk to you about Cancun, yeah, but Carly beat me to the punch.
I met you through Carly.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Now today, you're coming today to tell me Carly said.
No,
you can't be trusted. You got a pass, right?
Yeah, I got
you
a pass.
You used to be a whole stripper, so you probably
no,
still have
stripper,
that
but never a
mentality.
We don't give a about what Carly Red said. She said a lot of
surround.
And I don't give a about what nobody think about me or what nobody got to say.
Know that.
Well, we
that
don't know because
point.
Now they're saying you're the new line-ass bitch, so you might as well.
But why
I don't
am I
understand.
Lying? I don't want BK. I'm in a healthy, loving relationship.
And they say that.
BK cannot feel my husband's shoes.
And they say if he gonna do something, that's on him. I'm not with him either.
Hey. Why y'all was
having that much conversation?
Because he kept
trying
to talk to me.
I'm not doing that with your husband.
My husband won't be nowhere around you. No,
listen.
My husband a hoe.
Listen.
Pooh, you were supposed to come here, explain, and apologize, not call Sierra a hoe. You are your own worst enemy.
What are you saying? And you married. What? And you really need to get your ass up out of here. That's what you need to do. Because you're uninvited. Then nobody tell you to bring your ass up in here, Miss Richie Rich, like you were just gonna be welcome. Hell to the
this
no.
This ain't to be welcome into
baby,
Somebody need to knock her ass out real quick.
Come about who was saying, bitch, I stretched that hoe out.
Business at the glam shop has been growing. And now that I own the building, the salon, it's getting a facelift. I was supposed to meet up with Scrap the other night. But to be honest, until I figure out my true feelings with BK, I feel like it's only right that I just focus on my business and my shop renovations.
What you doing here?
I really feel terrible what happened the other day at Sierra House. I heard through the grapevine that Sierra's dating some other guy, but no arguments. We're just gonna do a lot of making up.
This look nice.
Thank you. But don't be just coming by here like everything is good.
Everything ain't
good. Last time I seen you, we was going neck to neck.
Yeah, I mean, but like I've been texting and trying to get at you. So who's this new guy?
What new guy?
I love you so much, and if you want to be happy with another person, I want you to.
Well,
but
honestly,
you know where your happiness is. I'm sorry. Do you forgive me? Please. This other guy don't mean nothing. I know he don't mean nothing to you. Because if he means something to you, you want me to let me hold your hand. You know you love me. And I love you. You're gonna go through crazy stuff in a relationship. No relationship is gonna be perfect.
BK and I's relationship is always up and down. After the fight, I must admit that I was a little petty for keeping our dog. And I was just hoping that BK would see me with Scrap so his ass can get mad.
You need to line up.
Listen,
and know that you have a queen.
So I'm saying I'm sorry. My heart is crying out for you. I don't want to lose you like this. Come home. You need to come home.
And if you f*** up again, don't lick them lips.
You know what I do with them
lips. So what that mean? What that mean?
Stop playing, man. You know I love you.
I love you, too.
My lawyer getting these evidence to free me up is nothing less than a miracle from God. And I need God to keep on working miracles to get Carly to chill out and not to get me in no more trouble. I invited Carly to church today. I know I need to make amends, and I don't want to lose my friend. I do miss Carly like crazy.
And my response is not to pull my nails. My response is not to bite my nails. My response.
It's a good thing that Sierra's making church a priority, because she needs it. She needs to get rid of that evil-ass energy.
I feel like I've just been so not myself lately.
Are you ready to talk to her? You can read the Bible, you can go to church, but if you don't apply it in life, it don't mean nothing.
I've been so disappointed in Sierra's lack of support. She's never been there for my divorce, and I still think she set me up. I came to hear her out because she's always been like a sister to me. But our friendship will never survive because you put your hands on me.
Hey.
Hi.
Look who we got here.
What's up, ladies?
Hello, ladies.
What's up?
Hey.
Spice.
What's up, what's up, what's up?
Hey. Hi, Carly.
I know I've talked to both of y'all. And all I told Sierra was, is this a friendship worth fighting for? Then reach out to Carly and y'all have a conversation.
Sierra, you know me, always gonna keep it real and tell you. I mean, I just feel like from Carly's point of view, it kind of feel like a setup because if the girl is your assistant, you're around her every day, so you probably know how she feel about Carly.
Carly, did I want them to jump on you? No, you are like my family. Yeah, what happened was wrong. I feel really messed up. Like, I feel messed up. And I just, I know you mad. I would be mad, too.
I apologize. Okay, yeah, we were going back and forth, but never did I one time ball my fist up.
We can argue so, till the sun come up, but
yeah.
I would never, ever in my life disrespect my friend and put my hands on her.
Sarah, calm down, and I'm just gonna leave you two to talk and get over it. If it's your friend, like Rashida said, fight for your friendship. And guess what? You're in church. You're from the one fighting at the house, Alila. They don't know the one who won.
Well, I don't know what you're saying, but yeah.
I see Sierra crying, but I don't believe those tears. Sierra cries over everything. Does she really care about me, or is she worried that I'm gonna press charges? I don't know, but what I do know, her behavior at that party made me realize that our friendship was never real.
Okay. First of all, the reason why I feel like you set me up, do you know the reason?
No, I don't.
When you seen them girls jumping, it was not one time you did. I didn't know. Carly, I wore a glueless wig with all my bald head edges out. You think I came to fight you that night? If you were in my shoes, you wouldn't trust me either.
And I understand. So how can I regain my trust back with my friend that I love? I want to know, like, how can I fix it? If you want to end our friendship, that's fine. I understand. But giving me closure in my heart is, I know I tried.
My best friend, her name is Karma. She gonna bite you in the ass.
We were actually just sitting here talking about the situation with Sierra's daughter.
It's crazy.
It's unfortunate that an adult had to be involved. Yeah. Like, come on now.
I'm just hearing little bits and pieces.
Wait a minute, y'all. It's getting ready. Come on, y'all. Wes, turn that up for us real quick.
The investigation is still going on, but what we know now is that just today, there was a fight inside of the bathroom on campus. A student helped her mom get onto the campus so they could team up and attack
the school
together. Sierra Gates has a lot of questions.
How did the mom get in that school?
Wow.
What type of person is you to even jump in a kid's fight?
Something like that, I would, all my would go out the window.
I can totally relate to Paris' situation. You know, it's not a good feeling actually getting jumped on by all these people.
How are you feeling about you and Sierra?
I reached out. I was like, I'm so sorry. If there's anything I can do, I have to put my aside.
Right, right.
Because yeah. Kids come before anything, you know. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to y'all. No, I don't trust her.
I reached out to Sierra as soon as this happened to let her know that, you know, I'm sorry that this happened to Paris. The first thing she said was, I know that if we were friends the way that we were, you would be here step by step. But at this point, I can't really trust her. It's just a sad situation all around.
It's gonna take some rebuilding with our friendship, but at the end of the day, if something happening with your child, I hope you would be there for me if something happened with my child.
Yeah.
And then maybe you guys could, you know, even further work it out.
If it's meant to be, that's all.
If it's possible.
Yeah.
We're not gonna force it.
We ain't forcing it.
Yeah, don't push it.
Okay.
But I'm gonna push that straw down your goddamn throat. You don't drink that damn drink. Nah,
I'm just kidding.
Do you believe in the fake or the real? The truth or the false? The word or the still? We live in a land where it's kill or be killed.
Baby, all right? Look like that. Sound like so mean. So what happened? I don't understand. Why would the girl mama get involved? What's happening? What's going on?
She said I was judging her.
Paris called me panicking.
Right.
Mom, the girl is up here with her mama in the bathroom. They about to fight me. So I'm like, what? I'm like, Paris, calm down. Put the girl mama on the phone. So Paris put the phone on speakerphone. And I said, hey, girl, what's going on? Mind you, this is the same lady that stayed in my building. So I'm thinking I can reason with this lady. In my head, I wanted to ask her, what the hell your grown ass doing at the school in the bathroom?
Right.
Next thing I know, Rod, I heard the phone drop. And little kids were screaming. Something needs to be done. Justice needs to be served. And let me get this clear. I'm not saying my daughter is innocent. I'm not saying that my daughter wasn't going back and forth with her daughter. But at the end of the day, they are children. She put her hands on my child.
Totally
on my 14-year-old child.
Totally
like, that's unacceptable.
Atlanta is a scary place to raise kids. You hear all the time about human trafficking, school shootings, and now this grown-ass lady has broken into the school to fight my 14-year-old daughter. My family has already lost so many people to violence. I don't know what I'll ever do if anything ever happened to her.
I think parents need to make better decisions.
You're right.
Stop thinking it's just a fight. It can be this small, end up this big. You lost your brother to nothing. You don't lost a sibling behind some bull. You want to go that same route? You have to make better decisions with your life. You know what I'm saying?
So what steps are you taking?
So you know I already filed the restraining order. So the girl and her child can't come around me or Paris. But I need her to stay over here with you until stuff gets moved over, and we need to figure out what our child is gonna do.
That's a good question. I'm trying to figure it out too. I don't wanna bear another child.
Thank you.
Where's Paris?
What's up, mother? Tell Tiffany thank you.
Thank you.
With all the stuff that my baby Paris has been through, she deserved to be spoiled tonight. Lots of friends and loved ones are coming out, but I decided to not invite Carly because my sister Trina is helping me out.
Hold on.
I didn't even know that my assistant had started fighting her.
It was definitely a setup.
I just don't want any drama tonight. And that's another reason why I did not invite BK Messy Ass.
Well, this right here is really good.
What is that?
Some she said they made up. So, friend, where is BK?
Girl, he broke in my house.
Broken house.
He had a key, but I've been calling him like, you need to drop my key off. So when me and Tiffany was in the house packing the bags for the party, he broke in with my key.
Oh, wow.
So I'm like, you need to give me my key.
That ain't a break-in.
That's dramatic. He broke in.
I blanked out on him, but at the end of the day, me and him been through some rough patches, and it got me on edge.
Excuse me. How everybody doing?
Delusional.
Hi. Appreciate y'all for coming.
Of course.
I got late, though. Trying to get Perry the gift.
I know. We got to give her the gift. But before I give her the gift, I need to talk to you about something. I'm glad you came over here.
What's up?
They really look cute together. Sad they couldn't work it out. Sugar, why you just can't do her right? She love you. And you love her. You need to go back out. Look at Sierra.
I just feel
Sierra like a goddamn Barbie doll. Ain't nobody you look better than her, brother. I'm sorry.
Whenever she comes talking about it, I plead the fifth. I ain't getting into all that old mess.
Ain't no bitch got nothing on her. I'm telling you, you better get your bitch back.
Kiyomi is pissed at me with all the drama that her and Cheyenne. So I was not gonna bring Kiyomi to my baby girl Paris' birthday party. Y'all already know how it is. We need God first, family second, and boy never.
Do you wanna hear from Macy?
Yes.
Come here, Macy.
Stop.
Chill. Look at your dad.
Why when you with me, it's all this. Loving, rocking you to sleep. No. And then when you with your daddy, it's like, all right,
mom. Is this when you with your dad? Show what it is with your dad.
Okay, but you my little baby.
He is a kid, dad.
So I don't act like that.
We gon' end this because we gotta give your sister a present. Okay, Rod, well, you make the announcement. Make the announcement.
Y'all meet my side.
How about that?
Meet us outside. Paris.
Meet my side.
Paris. Meet us outside.
This way. This way.
What way?
This way, baby. Give me a hand, Papa. Oh, what's that? Look at that.
Hey, yo, it's Safari. Listen, thanks for watching, and you are now tuned in with the brand new Love & Hip Hop YouTube, all right? Subscribe. Click it. There's a button right there. Hit it right there and subscribe, all right? Cheer!